Elon Musk claims that Neuralink, a startup that specializes in brain-computer interfaces, or BCI, will likely begin human testing by the middle of 2023. Musk, the founder of Tesla, SpaceX, and Twitter, said that the BCI firm might implant one of its devices in a person's head in 6 months, or perhaps in 2023, at an event that appeared to be another recruiting drive for Neuralink. In this video, we will be discussing all the important aspects and uses of Neuralink in 2023. Before starting the video, please subscribe to my channel and sit back and relax. Now let's get started. You'd be excused if you'd forgotten that Elon Musk is also working on brain implants, with all the hype surrounding his takeover of Twitter, sending rockets to Mars, developing self-driving electric cars, and building a humanoid robot. Yes, we are referring to brain implants for microchips. Long-term aims for Neuralink are quite ambitious. Much like the aspirations for many of Elon Musk's initiatives, they aspire to eventually develop a human-computer interface that will enable us to communicate with computers solely through our minds. The immediate goal, however, is to restore function to those who have suffered brain or spinal cord injuries. At a recent Neuralink presentation, Musk said that the device's early uses may include giving the blind their vision back and perhaps regaining the ability to walk for paralyzed individuals. Now, let's move to the question of how does Neuralink function. Neuralink's main concept is that it will have the ability to read human minds. And how will it achieve that? Neuralink will be made to connect to thousands of neurons in our brains. According to its website, the cells that make up our brain and central nervous system are known as neurons. It is the process through which the mental command to pick up that glass moves from a thought to a physical movement of the arm and hand. The idea behind Neuralink is that it can comprehend messages and put them into action for us by connecting these neurons in our brains. This would be an absolute game changer for those with brain damage or issues with motor function. Imagine someone who had ALS and was unable to speak or use their hands with ease. People in this position may find it very challenging to communicate. They only needed to think about what they wanted to say for Neuralink to communicate it over Bluetooth to a smart speaker or other devices so that it could utter it for them. They might be able to use their minds as a keyboard and mouse to browse the internet, place orders for groceries, or even make appointments. It is truly the stuff of science fiction movies, and if it functions as designed, will change the game. Elon Musk has said that for those with severed spinal cords, we're certain that there are no physical constraints to restoring complete body functionality. In terms of longer-term applications, the options are practically limitless. By serving as a link between various sections of the brain, it may be able to help people with disabilities enhance their memory and cognitive function. Like any cutting-edge technology, there is probably a ton of use cases that won't be apparent until the technology is widely used. One of the most important developments in Neuralink is that the human trials for Neuralink might begin around 2023. Neuralink aired a live session last month where an update on the businesses, technology, and aspirations was given. Elon Musk spoke on the broadcast for a while, sharing his perspective on the process for obtaining FDA approval, as well as his goals for the business. One of the presentation's most significant announcements was that Neuralink had submitted an application to the FDA seeking permission to start conducting human studies. Yes, it's possible that human brains may soon be implanted with microchips in less than a year. You could think that implementing this technology is ridiculous and question why anyone would sign up for it. The truth is that this has great potential advantages for people with severe disabilities. We won't know the specifics of those who volunteer for the trials, but it's reasonable to assume that a sizable fraction of them could stand to have the technology potentially transform their lives once the devices are prepared and cleared for human usage. Elon Musk has even said that he intends to get one implanted himself. It's also important to note that this kind of technology has been used before. Implanting a device that sends electrical pulses into the vagus nerve and into the brainstem is known as vagus nerve stimulation. It's a method of treating epilepsy as well as mental health issues, including depression. Another illustration is the cochlear implant, which is inserted beneath the skin and transmits audio information to the auditory nerve. The point is that scientists and engineers aren't starting from scratch when it comes comes to connecting technology to our brains and nervous system. Yes, both of these devices are significantly more basic than what Neuralink is hoping to do. Well, it's nearly impossible that Elon Musk and controversy do not go hand in hand. So what's? The controversy surrounding Neuralink is not without criticism, despite all these intriguing claims. But again, what else would you anticipate from a business led by Elon Musk? Most recently, a rumored inquiry into their procedures for using animals for research put them in the news. It's been claimed that over 1,500 animals, including pigs, sheep, and monkeys, were murdered during testing. Although that might sound alarming, the terrible reality is that it happens frequently in the medical and pharmaceutical sectors. The fact that these many animals were harmed during the testing period does not necessarily mean that Neuralink is acting improperly before testing on people. Animal testing is an essential step in the development of novel pharmaceuticals and medical technologies to ensure their safety and effectiveness. However, there have been claims that there have been more animal deaths than necessary. Now, you might be thinking about the uses of Neuralink. Don't worry, we will disclose the list to you. Number 1. For visual prosthesis. According to a Neuralink engineer who works in the visual neuroscience division, this technology may be able to offer visual prostheses to those who have suffered retinal damage or eye injuries that resulted in blindness. To create a visual image, a huge array of hundreds or perhaps tens of thousands of electrodes is stimulated by effectively plugging a camera into the visual cortex. In the future, possibly a heads-up display can be created using the same technologies. Elon Musk remarked that we could truly delegate oversight to someone. Radar, ultraviolet, infrared, and other wavelengths can all be used to view the world, to have a superhuman vision. All one needs to do is essentially specify their frequency and dynamically alter the sensor. Number 2. For telepathy may be the next frontier for Neuralink. According to one of the company's key chip designers, he said that putting thoughts into words requires a tremendous lot of effort. These words are a condensed version of our enormous mental power. Musk weighed in on this theory as well, stating that words have a very low data rate and that we use a lot of mental energy trying to condense the ideas and concepts in our heads into words. One could converse more effectively and send truer thoughts with Neuralink. This communication was described by Musk as a non-linguistic assent consenting intellectual telepathy. Number 3 is an oscilloscope for the brain. Oscilloscopes show information about printed circuit boards visually on PCBs. Similarly to this, the Neuralink device can illuminate a variety of brain activities. One of the team members commented the side effect of this device is you'll wind up learning a ton about how the brain works. Number 4. Nostalgia on demand. Memories vanish through narratives. They are changed and modified. The initial version is no longer present as the years go up. Unfortunately, even while this seems like it might have come straight out of a memento, it is. So a team member suggested that memories may serve as repositories. Like music, a memory can be revisited at any time to change the mood. Once this is solved, cognitive problems like dementia will be simple to treat. Number 5. AI symbiosis. Musk reminded everyone that from the perspective of our species, it will be crucial to determine how we can live in harmony with highly developed artificial intelligence and develop some form of AI symbiosis in which an AI extension of oneself functions as a tertiary layer above the limbic system and cortex. To have a planet in the future that is governed by the collective will of the inhabitants of the Earth, having that symbiosis can be beneficial. According to Musk, achieving a solid AI symbiosis will be crucial from the perspective of an existential threat, and that may be Neuralink's most significant result. And that's a wrap, guys. Whatever the consequences would be, Musk is thinking big this time with Neuralink. What is your opinion on this? Do you also think that Neuralink can change the game of future technology? Let us know in the comments section below. Thank you for sticking to the end. If you liked the video, make sure to subscribe to my channel and be notified of future updates.